This week we are continuing on the stunt fishing mission that we started last week. We have set out from the west coast of New Zealand's South Island to catch a giant bluefin tuna. These immensely powerful fish are tough enough to catch even with the very best big game fishing tackle. But what I hope to do is catch one from a 4 meter boat with a hand line. The trouble is, the wild weather has kept us shorebound, and while ashore in Westport, I was given a stern warning from a local commercial fisherman about the perils of fighting a giant tuna from my dinghy.
Told me, don't do it, you'll get yourself killed.
This warning and a dodgy weather forecast has forced us into plan B. We would now head out in our much bigger support boat for a practice run. First, we locate a hoki trawler where the giant tuna feed on the scraps being discharged overboard. Then, after hours of trying, I finally hook up on a giant tuna. And now, I am in for the fight of my life with a fish almost five times my size.
Clip the harness on me! Clip the harness on me! Get the harness on me! Clip it on! Clip it on! Holy! Be careful of this rope, man, it's going!
Oh, we have to work to hook this one. We have to absolutely work. So much perseverance. And hooking it is just the very first part of this process. Careful, mate, just be very careful on that. My hands are sore already. What have I got myself into here? No, we're pretty good at the moment, Wooly. Just the line's on quite a steep angle out the back. Yeah, I know, it's quite steep. It's pretty. Just maybe tick it in gear and left hand down just a little bit, please. Just so we can, it'll get the rope out to the side, eh? We'll try and fight it off the side a bit more. Just reverse slowly, mate. Reverse slowly. Coming back, Wooly. Keep coming back, mate, I'm losing.
This giant tuna has ripped out almost all of my 250 metres of rope.
Probably only got about 10 metres left, actually.
And with no chance of holding this fish, I need Wooly to chase the fish with the boat. If we get to the end of the line, the power of this tuna is enough to break the leader or even straighten the hook. I've only got a few metres of rope left to play with, and things are getting pretty tense.
We're getting real low on line, eh? Slow down, Wooly! Fish is diving deep now.
That's a very good point that Ian, our underwater cameraman, made. He said if someone put out 250 metres of anchor rope, you wouldn't pull it in. Let alone your anchor weighing 200 plus kilos and having the power like no other fish in the ocean. There's no way I'd pull an anchor in, but for some reason, something's possessed me to want to try and pull a giant tuna in.
Oh, we're just trying to go back down.
Thank you, mate. Changing over my glove to my heavy duty glove, because when I get down to the leader on the end, it's going to be really, really tough to hang on, not like the soft rope. My hands are so cramped. Okay, mate. It's burning, man, it's burning. The scary thing is, while I'm getting line back, this fish doesn't appear to be working really hard. He could just be cruising along. The hook not even bothering them. We're using a circle hook so we can release these fish in good condition. The downside to that for me is that it doesn't hurt the fish. Forward, Wooly, please, forward. Go, go, go. Okay, slow, 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 slow. It's getting close now. One thing we know for sure is these big bluefin have been with that trawler all day, feeding up on hoki, so it's going to have plenty of energy. More than me, by the seam. Okay, we've got a bit of line angle, Wooly. Just tick backwards slowly, please. I'm losing line. Just tick backwards slowly. Just get ready to go forward. Okay, neutral.
Neutral.
Right hand down, reverse
right hand
hard
down,
attack.
Reverse.
Hard down, just slightly.
Slowly.
Nah, neutral.
Neutral.
He's not far away at all. He's changing his pattern. Okay, just neutral now, Wooly. That rope's just so much tension on it. Keep going, Wooly. Left hand down. Just spiral around it if you have to.
As the tuna nears the surface, it goes into a circular swimming pattern. As the line swings around, we have to maneuver the boat to prevent the line hitting the propeller. Wooly's unable to see the line angle, so I have to shout instructions to ensure the tuna doesn't get under the boat.
Neutral, get ready to go right. Get ready to go right, but stay neutral. He's arcing right over towards Ian. Just about got the leader. Oh, I just don't want to give up. Left hand forward, go mate. Forward, please, mate. Just straight forward. I don't need this right at the end. Drama I could do without. Come on, baby. I've got a wrap on the leader now, Wooly. There's a big fish down there. There's a big fish down there. Here he is. Get ready, Dilt. Forward, Wooly, just slowly. Go neutral, go neutral. Look at that, coming up there. It's a big one, mate. Okay, tag him, tag him. Yeah, we're clear, don't panic. Okay, here we go, boy. Here we go, get him.
Yeah.
You got him?
Yeah.
Tag's in him. Woohoo! He's tagged. Now we've just got to successfully manage this release. It's important, we've got the shots, look at that.
That's a 300.
That's 300 kilo?
That's a 300 kilo one.
That is, that's the biggest one I've ever seen by a long shot.
There you go.
Oh yeah.
That is a magnificent fish.
Look at that. You can get some appreciation of the size that is a barrel. See if you can get me in the photo as well, Dill, if you can please, mate. Okay. Come on, baby. Come on, Kate, keep rolling. Come on, Kate, come on, Kate. There you go, I've got to get a photo of this. I mean, it's very tempting to take a fish like this home. They're so magnificent to eat. Look at the size of it. Awesome. There you go.
That's a 300
kilo fish out. Okay. We don't want to muck around. 320, easy? Okay, no worries. Okay. Okay. Away you go, buddy.
Have a good day, mate.
That is awesome. Look at it.
Yes!
Oh, thanks awesome, so much, Dave. Thanks so much, Dave. Now that is what you call earning a fish, man. Thanks so much, team.
Yeah.
I don't know about doing that in a dinghy, seriously. But then again, I might feel differently about that in the morning.
Let's go and get another one.
Okay, let's go get another one. Your turn now, Dill.
Okay, Dylan.
It had to be three, or was it, like you got a 300 kilo one last year. How much bigger were it?
298, they would have been
350.
350?
Yeah.
Rounder, longer, awesome fish.
It was big fish.
Awesome.
I mean, I've got nothing to compare it to. I mean, we got one that we let go last year, the one that snapped the hook, we reckon was about 320, and that was a bigger fish, I reckon.
We got one on Wednesday, it was 248. That was the next size up again.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Big fish.
There you go, if that had been caught on rod and reel, potential world record then. But hey, records don't mean anything to me. All right! Well, we've run straight back up and found ourselves another trawler. I've well and truly put the hand line away. That's certainly enough for me for one day, but Dylan's stepping up to the plate this time. The bait's going in, same process, and hopefully we hook up. What we found last time was that we hooked my fish on a small bait, 300 kilo plus fish. This is a bait, it's probably the size of what I'd use for a snapper, but we're matching the hatch. What these tuna are doing is following behind, eating the processing waste. Little wee blocks of fish, just like that one there, are floating out the back of this trawler. We found the big baits isn't what they're eating, they're ignoring them. This thing here, well, to a bluefin tuna, that's dinner. Okay, we're actually, the bait's actually hit the boat there. That's how close it is coming. Now these ships look like they're standing still. They're actually moving forward at about 4 or 5 knots. They are so huge they don't get affected by the sea. Now our bait's just running down along the side. Okay, it's been bit. Turn the chair. Don't tighten up too much yet. Go forward, Wally, forward. Go. Start tightening up. Oh, it's on the boat. Okay, we got some rub on the boat, Wally. Tighten up a little bit. Slow the boat down. It swam straight under the boat. It got some rub as the chair came around. Swam straight under the boat. I don't think it's bad though, mate, but it's just something. Okay, we're onto the backing already. What's that? Yeah, I will. I'm just gonna... Okay, I'm just going to get organised and then I'll talk him right through it, mate. It's not a bad thing. I mean, this fish, I can hardly hear myself think. It's screaming out line. This is a 130-pound tackle. To give you some idea of what these fish can do, that's incredible. But it's not a bad thing for Dylan that the fish is taking so much line, because the fish is going to be tiring itself out. When it's our turn, hopefully we'll be able to slow the fish down, work him up, and get him up while he's tired. That's if he ever gets tired and we don't run out of line. What do you reckon? Okay, you can take that clicker off whenever you're ready, Dil. Flick that clicker off when you're ready. Yeah, that's it. Okay, just concentrate on keeping tight. I'm going to be right with you. That fish is going to be charging around. The good thing that we need to know, mate, is that it's on a circle hook, so they can't really shake those hooks out. Okay, so it's not a real bad thing if we get a little bit of slack. Well, wind hard, mate, doesn't really matter. You just grind hard because it's going to be easy line for you, okay? Because trust me, it's going to get hard soon enough. Yeah. Okay, yep, slow us down, Wooly. Okay, this fish is starting to sound now. After the big long screaming run, the fish was kind of relaxed on the surface, swimming towards us and gave Dylan some easy line back. It took about 250, 300 metres of that 130-pound line in no time, but Dylan's worked it back in just a few minutes. But this is where the hard work's going to begin. Once this fish digs its head down, that's it. That's the way to use that gear. You'll notice Dylan now is using his legs to lift the rod, not his arms. Your quads are a lot stronger muscles than your arms.
Go forward, Dad.
Oh, Dil's got some big guns. Forward, just forward, Wooly. Forward, mate.
Keep going.
That's it, mate. Just keep ticking forward. Keep ticking forward. When that line comes close, rock forward to give the line clearance. Yeah, like if you have to, go forward like that. Yep, give it some clearance. Okay, that line's cranking under a bit of pressure. That's it, mate. Are you up on strike? Yep. So is this, you reckon this is better than playing rugby, mate?
Or yes, for sure.
School hockey team?
Yeah. School around,
though. Okay, it's the school holidays, isn't it? It's Saturday. You're better off, like honestly, we're better off going hard now and the line breaking now from that rub than in 5 hours' time.
Yep.
Okay, so we could always go back and hook another one.
Yep.
Sweet, okay, go.
Wooly is desperate for his son to catch this tuna. Together, Wooly and Dylan have hooked and lost 5 of these giant tuna. So understandably, Wooly is a little bit anxious.
Okay, just... Now you can really start to hear that tension going. Last time we fished down here on rod and reel, we were fishing on 80-pound tackle, and people couldn't get over the amount of strain that was going on our gear. This is a 130-pound tackle, almost twice as much. And Dylan's just doing a stellar job there, working this really, really heavy tackle. This fishery is unreal. long's that now?
Just on an hour.
An hour. Oh, well, time for our hourly report. How are you feeling?
Good. Ready for another 4.
Ready for another 4 hours. You see, Dylan has experienced fighting one of these before. I mean, you can see the way he's using the tackle. He's got a bit of experience. He's fought one for 5 hours only to lose it. So he's paid his dues. We're only an hour in, but this fish is getting very close. Just board a touch, Wally. Just a touch, that'll do, that'll do. Okay, we're gonna get a look at this fish soon. It's come right up on the surface here. Oh yeah, look at that line.
Wind, wind, wind. Okay, Wally, get ready to go forward, mate. Get ready to go, get, okay, just go forward, Wally. Go, mate. Just go, we're running parallel. Go forward, Wally. Okay, the fish is out here. Okay, if anything, to bail out, if we have to, you're gonna have to go right hand down. There he is, he's right on the surface there. Look at his tail, sickle. Just keep, bring up that leader to me, bro. Bring up that leader to me. For the last 10 minutes, the fish has been within sort of 20 meters of us. It's just really being stubborn. It's going crazy all over the place. But this is a little bit like deja vu with one of the big turns that we had on last year with a trawler bearing down on us. And I don't want to preempt anything, but look at this over here. It's still about half a mile away now behind that swell there. But last time it got from that far away to on top of us in no time. It was quite incredible. Okay, keep winding, Dil.
Yeah.
Letting go. Still got heaps of stoke, man.
You can hear that tension just cracking off. Dylan's pulling about 30 kilograms of drag there, or near on it, which is a lot. Okay, are you in high gear, mate? Stay in high while he's on the top, mate. Stay in high while he's on top.
Wide, 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 wide. Okay, Wooly, get ready to go forward, mate. Keep going. Keep going. Forward, Wooly. Forward, mate. Forward. Go, mate. Go, mate. Just go. Just go. We're running parallel. Go forward, Wooly. Okay, the fish is out here. Okay, stop winding. Stop winding. Got
him. Nice work, bro.
No, no, take your time, take your time. Okay, here's your shot, put it in him. Pull it right in, pull the rope, pull the rope hard. Come, it's alright. Okay, this one, we want you to come in underneath this one, underneath, mate, underneath with this one. Oh, no, it's not a good one. Yeah. Pull it in hard, pull that rope hard. The rope's the one you want. Okay, yeah, get rid of that handle. Get rid of that handle, okay? Just keep tension on those gap ropes. We've got 2 gaps in this fish, but it's still gonna take some time to subdue. We've got to kind of work around to the back. Well done on that fish, Dil, you got this in super quick, man. Okay, we're going to get him around through here. Okay, yeah, we've got to try and work that header. That is a big fish. That is a big fish. Awesome, Dil. I think that'll do it, man.
Yeah.
That's good enough for a worldie. A world record, bro. All right. Well done, Wooly. Hey,
awesome, man.
A good example of, you know, fishing, be it fishing off a wharf or for snapper, fathers and sons or fathers and daughters or all family inclusive thing fishing. And when you can, I mean, it's got to just about be the pinnacle when you can get a fish like this. This is huge, a world record. And not only that, they taste fantastic as well. So we're going to be eating like kings, and I think maybe a few celebratory ones tonight. I think Dylan, mate, maybe we might stretch a shandy for you tonight, mate.
I'm stoked. That's the only words I can think of.
Awesome, man. You worked that like a pro, man. That tackle.
Sunshine, give it to your dad. Apple juice! Yay!
After a long trip back to Westport, we were eager to find out exactly what Dylan's tuna weighed. So first thing in the morning, it was hoisted up on the scales, where it registered a whopping 222.8 kilograms, a new New Zealand juniors record and the biggest Northern Pacific bluefin tuna ever caught by a junior anywhere in the world.
Definitely hard work, unlike anything I've ever fought before.
Would you do it again?
Without a thought, definitely, in a second.